Bulls ass. Chipper the tram engine, his cow catches in sad place. They help to prevent animals getting hurt if they stray on the lane. Daisy thought they were a sitter. She said Chipper was afraid of getting hurt himself. Look, you're not afraid, said Chipper indignantly. Well, if not got stupid cow catchers, it had not frightened. It just toot and they'd all get away, get out of the way. But they toot to that sort of thing, said Chipper simply. They would with me. Animals always run if you toot and look them in the eye. Even bulls? Even bulls, said Daisy confidently. Daisy had never met a bull, but she purred away, quite ever unconcerned. Chipper was thinking, she's becoming ever annoying. What a stupid diesel car. At a level crossing, cars waited behind the gates to let her pass. She tooted at the farm crossing, and horse and cart halted while she went by. Pooh, she said, it's easy. It's just tooting the old sinner's head. Her little chubby. And sorry, he straightened. At the next station, a policeman was waiting. There's a boy in the lab. Warn them, please drive it along towards the farmer. Daisy, super excited, and a bit proud. Now she thought, I'll show Chipper how to manage bulls. But she would never show Chipper how to manage bulls. Chipper would show her. Champion, which was the bull's name, wasn't rarely a fast bull. But this morning he was cross, because I had driven him away before he'd finished breakfast. He hadn't just had half of it. And tried to put him in a kettle flute. They pulled him and pushed him and prodded him and slapped him, but he wouldn't go. He broke away and trotted down the road. He saw a fence, jumped it, and slithered down the slope. Champion Sabre surprised. This is a new kind of field. It had a brown track at the bottom, but there was plenty of grass on its side, and he was still hungry. He remembered he'd ate half of breakfast. She decided to continue on the rest in it. Now for my breakfast, he thought. Daisy saw the bull and thought of a chance to shoot it to the farmer. Oh, tooted Daisy. Go on! Champion had his back to her. He was too busy to pay any attention. Oh, said Dice again. But Champion did not listen. He ignored her horn and went on eating. This is all wrong, thought Dice. How can I look him in the eye? If he won't turn round. Oh! At last, Champion turned and noticed Daisy. Moo, he said, you've upset my You've stopped me eating off my breakfast. And it came towards her, still chewing. He wondered what she was. Oh, said Dicey cheaply. It isn't a girl, why? The garden, the policeman, church shoot champion. But he wouldn't stay shoot. As soon as they turned away, he came back. He was a most inquisitive animal. Go on, Dicey, said the driver. It's harmless. Yes, said Dicey unhappily. You know he's harmless, and I know he's harmless, but does he know? It says, look at his horns. If I bump into him, he might hurt me. Them. The farmer like that. Champion came close and sniffed on Dicey's eyes. Woof, she said, backing away hastily. Chirper, she was surprised to find Dicey once more back at the station. The passengers turned him about the ball. He chuckled. Balls always run if you toot and look them in the eye, eh, Dicey? Dicey said nothing. But she said to him, he just didn't shoo why. But just sniffed at my face. Chirpy laughed a little bit. He's funny, and ever strange, silly. Oh well, Chirpy went on. You live and learn. I'd better chase him for you, I suppose, in a clanked way. Chirpy found the ball, Champion. The Champion took no notice of Chirpy's bell or whistle. He didn't move till Chirpy pushed him with steam. Then Chirpy ever gently shooed him along the track to where the farmer and his men were waiting. There you are, said Chirpy. It's a good thing I finished breakfast, said the bull. Dicey, in an exhausting day, Chirpy and Percy often met her on their journeys, and though they never mentioned balls, they gave her pitching looks. It made her very cross. Would you mind not chasing me like that? She said. Sorry, they said. She was feeling disappointed and ever sad because she didn't get the chance to chirp. She was ever good at shooing balls. A last journey ended at the top station. Some boys on the platform. Suddenly, one of them came running, holding a paper bag. And what was in the paper bag, they were holding, was something that they liked to eat. Look, he shouted, I've got a quarter of bull's eyes. He liked them. And a super, I think, don't you? They shoved the switch and sucked them happily. Stutter. Keep your ear, bull's ears. And she scuttled to a shed, but still very sad and sorry for himself. And that's the end of this big story. Turn to me. Right back.